Welcome. Let's talk about a very important topic in environment, that is the National Action Plan on Climate Change. Now, this has been India's very important initiative. Now, we'll understand two things first. Why there was a need for an action plan and how actually it happened. So, let's talk about how it happened. If you look onto the performances across the country, India is considered 12th most vulnerable country in terms of the calamities or the disasters that could occur due to climate change. And that is one of the findings of the global risk, the Global Climate Risk Index laid down in 2018, which is given by German Watch, a non-profit organization. Now, this report says that India is the 12th most vulnerable. However, this report was post the National Action Plan on Climate Change, which came in 2008. But the idea here is to bring to your observation that with the climate change, you would have issues of floods, droughts, storms that could occur, severe dry conditions that could occur. So, vector-borne diseases that could occur. So, all these are an implication of climate change. Now, in 2007, China released the National Action Plan for Climate Change. And it was in line with that, that there was a requirement before the G8 summit to occur in 2009, India should have something which is considered as a draft for the National Action Plan on Climate Change. So, the G8 summit in 2008 in Tokyo and the Conference of Parties at Copenhagen in 2009 were the two landmarks before which India wanted to have something. Now, why there was actually a need for the plan? We have nearly 487 million people across India who do not have access to electricity. There are nearly 80% of the population which is living at a daily wage of $2 or less per day. So that's the poverty line levels in India that we have seen, and nearly 34% of the population below $1 per day. Similarly, we are talking about improving the GDP. So if we are focusing on a GDP of 8% and more in the next 25 years, we need to give a thrust to the bottom 40% of the citizens in India. And with these ideas in mind, you had the draft for the action plan that was laid down. Prior to this action plan, we had numerous other strategies that were there. Now, these were the rural electrification policy. You have the Bachat Lamp Yojana. You had the hydroelectric initiative, the energy conservation initiative. So, those were some of the major initiatives that were there. Integrated Energy Policy 2006. So, all this emphasized on much more energy efficient way of progress, use of more renewable sources of energy. Besides the National Action Plan on Climate Change, we also have some other schemes like the International Solar Alliance. We have the FAME scheme, which is mainly for the e-mobility that is there. The Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana, Atal Mission for Rejuvenation and Urban Transformation, the Amrit scheme, which we have covered in a separate lecture, Ujjala Bharat. Then you have the Swachh Bharat Mission. So all those are part of a initiative towards much more efficient, energy efficient system that could be generated. Now coming on to the National Action Plan. So National Action Plan for Climate Change, what was the principle for this? The idea was to protect the poor. As we said, if we want to grow our GDP, we need to give a thrust to the bottom 40% of the population. So bringing poor in an inclusive framework, achieving a national growth and poverty alleviation program, working with cost-effective strategies, bringing in more systematic market regulatory conditions that could occur, and a kind of better implementation that should be there with the public-private partnership. So with this principle, you had 8 missions that were released under the National Action Plan on Climate Change. So let's talk about these 8 missions one by one. So let's first talk about the mission on sustainable habitat. Now this sustainable habitat talks about energy efficiency mainly in the urban areas. Now the amount of carbon dioxide emissions from the main metropolitans, the 7 major metro cities across India, is nearly around 2.7 tons while from other countries it's merely 1.5 ton. So that's very high average per capita carbon dioxide emissions that we could say that are coming from these countries, from these cities. So definitely sustainable habitat becomes important. Now how does it come actually into play? Through the Amrit scheme, you have the energy efficient building code, energy conservation building code that is there, waste management, recycling of the waste, power production from the waste. Those are some of the ways under which you can have a sustainable habitat. The next is enhanced energy efficiency. Now, enhanced energy efficiency talks about a much more energy efficient system where we are talking about yielding more than 10,000 megawatts of savings by 2012. So that was the target. So the idea was a PAT, and PAT was perform, achieve and trade. With that idea, we laid down the enhanced energy efficient program. Then you have the water mission, which is started in 2011. The idea was to improve water security and accessibility of the water to the rural areas. The national mission on strategic knowledge for climate change is very important. It laid down sensitive economic sectors. Now those were in the form of agriculture, water, sustainable habitat, manufacturing that was seen, forestry and energy efficiency. So those were the kind of goals that were set under the strategic knowledge for climate change. The next is the solar mission. Now we already are aware of the Jawaharlal Nehru solar mission, which was the prior idea. Later on it was the national solar mission that was laid down. The idea is to enhance the capacity of renewable energy in the country. Started in 2010, and later on we now talk about even the collaboration with International Solar Alliance and the way forward with at least 100 gigawatts of solar energy by 2022. So that's the mission that we have been working for. You have the sustainable agriculture. The idea is to give a climate proof agriculture, develop crops which are much more climate resilient. As a result, the extreme conditions of the climate won't be affected by it, won't affect it. Okay, and the next is the Green India mission. So this sustainable agriculture talked about some subcomponents. First was the soil health management. The next was the rain-fed area development. It focused on agroforestry and also on a kind of climate change and sustainable development monitoring model. Then the Green India mission. The Green India mission, the idea was to increase the forest cover across country. This is started in 2014. And finally, you have the sustainable mission for Himalayan ecosystem, that is mainly for the Himalayan belt. And this got started since 2014. So Green India mission and the sustainable mission for Himalayan ecosystem started in 2014, both aimed at protecting the trees, protecting the forest cover, with a special reference to Himalayan ecosystem in the mission for sustaining the Himalayan ecosystem. So those are the 8 important missions which are part of the National Action Plan on Climate Change. That could be one of the direct questions, and then each of those require a lot of details. So we'll be covering each of those under different lectures separately. So stay tuned for many further updates. Have a wonderful day ahead.